There is one another disaster similar to earthquake, that is fire. There may be reasons for an outbreak of fire. Fire can be natural or a man-made disaster. There are four types of fires. The first is a class of fire which is a solid substance that is cooled and is extinguished. This includes fire from wood, clothing, paper. This is type A fire. The second type of fire is called type B fire. This kind of fire is due to the liquid substance which can catch fire instantly. Examples include fire caused by petrol, oil, vernal, liquid, cooking oil, dye, etc. Such a fire is extinguished by using a fire extinguisher. The domestic LPG gas is a highly inflammable fuel product. The fire caused by this is dangerous and can cause disasters. This type is type C fire, and this type of fire is due to gaseous substances. Chemicals are also involved in the burning of flammable metals such as potassium, sodium, calcium, etc. This type of fire is type D. Aluminium or zinc reacts with water at high temperatures, and so when exposed to water causes a flare up. Water is useful for extinguishing fire due to wood or clothes. When water is used to extinguish fire, it gives a cooling effect. Sand and soil are used to extinguish fire by liquid substances like petrol, oil and edible oil, etc. Substances like foam can be used. It can be used as a cover. If there are flammable substances, these substances need to be removed. Objects like wooden furniture should be removed from the site of fire. A stir pump is a great way to extinguish fire. The most important things are to make fire pits and to take protective measures to prevent fire. For safety purpose, we should switch off the gas cylinder regulator when it is not in use, switch off all lights and electrical appliances when you are leaving the premises. We all need to get into this habit. When there is a fire, we should call people for help and inform the fire brigade as soon as possible. Also, we should be aware of how the fire brigade works at the time of fire. We should also know about the right first aid to be given if a person is injured due to fire. We often hear the news about landslides happening around the world. In rainy season, the landslides occur due to heavy rains. This is one of the most important disasters which affects the lives as well as the property. The rainwater percolates in the rocks beneath the earth's surface. This results in disintegration of rocks into smaller pieces, and these pieces loosen up in the soil. These smaller rock pieces move down the hill slope due to the gravitational force of the earth. This is called a landslide. Earthquake, tsunami, heavy rainfall, cyclone and floods are the disastrous activities happening on the earth. In this modern era, man has cut trees. This results in soil wash and soil erosion. For construction of roads and buildings, hills and mountains are being dug up. The rocks and the soil becomes loose. When the rainwater mixes in this loosened soil and rocks, the chances of landslide increases. A landslide results in the roadblocks and traffic jams, flooding of rivers and changes in their flow. Sometimes due to the depression in the land, a new water body may be created. Sometimes the vegetation is destroyed. These kinds of calamities can happen near us. So we students should be alert for these disasters. We should make a planning for disaster management. For this, what can you do? Write the name of your school, address, name of the headmaster, address of the headmaster, founder of the school, manager, and number of employees working in the school. Write information about them. Form a disaster management committee in your school. Make a map for disaster management. That map should have information about the school building, playground, assembly point, etc. Students can perform plays and dramas on disaster that can happen in school and how to take care. In this way, the students will be prepared for any disaster in the future and they can prevent loss of lives and property.